is Shoptalk, and I'm Ria Tanjuatco Trillo. The trend to use organic products may have started a few years ago, but demand for such products continues to grow as more and more consumers prefer items made of organic ingredients. Today, we'll talk to two entrepreneurs who make organic bath and body products to know more about the businesses they've set up and to see some of the products they make. So in this first segment, we're joined by JUDY MAPUA DYTIANDU. She is the owner of Planet Noa, a company she started almost 4 years ago. And Planet Noa has two brands, Oasis and Botany Works. Hello, JUDY, and thank you for coming to the show.
Thank you.
Okay, give us a quick background story of Planet Noa. You gave birth to Planet Noa just about the same time you gave birth to Noa, your son.
Yes, about when it all started by accident, actually. I wasn't really planning to get into this kind of business, but it just happened when my son was around 2 months old. So he was diagnosed with a skin asthma or eczema, which is what they call it. And I consulted a few doctors about it. And what I learned was it's standard prescription drugs and creams that contain, you know, harsh ingredients. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to stay away from these harsh products. So I did my research, and I had the support of our pediatrician, who is into natural medicine also. So I found that there are a lot of alternatives out there, natural remedies that are actually good for the skin. So that's how it started, and I tried them on my son,
and they worked.
And they worked.
And after that, that's how you decided to, you know, to make
them. I wanted to share that to others, and that's how it started.
Right, okay, so you have two lines. Oasis is the baby line, and then you have Botany Works, which is your aromatherapy line. But okay, let's talk about Oasis first. You have four products in that line, and I have some right here next to me, okay? This is the Oasis Soothing Butter Cream. Okay, so how would one use this on their baby?
Just like any cream, you can use it as a diaper cream or a moisturizer.
Okay.
It's very good for very
That's
dry.
Right.
Yeah, you're smelling lavender.
Yeah.
Yeah. And lavender is very good for the skin also, for any inflammation, any soreness.
Mm-hmm. Could you use this, like, I know some babies get cradle caps, they get, like, flaky heads.
Yes.
Right? Can this be used on that also?
Yes. Actually, for cradle cap particularly, I would suggest the baby oil.
Oh, okay. And what base do you use for this one?
The main base are vegetable oils. There's a lot of virgin coconut oil.
Okay. Which is nice because you can source it here.
Yes. Right? Yeah. Locally sourced. There's avocado oil. Mm-hmm. And there's the healing ingredients, the aloe vera, calendula, chamomile, lavender, and some other vegetable oils mixed in.
That's so good. I mean, babies already smell good by themselves, but you add this, that's great.
Yeah, especially right after bath.
Right.
So they put it on and it smells really, really nice.
Right. So this one can be used as a moisturizer for cradle cap or whatever. But
or massage,
like,
or
the more intense or the more moisturizing one is this one, right? The butter cream.
Well, not really. Actually, personally, I prefer the baby oil because
okay.
It's easily absorbed. It's pure oil, so it's the body readily absorbs that.
Oh, okay. Yes. Nice also to use when you massage your baby, right?
Yes, very calming for the baby.
Yeah, it smells great. Okay, you mentioned the bath, and you also have, like, bath salts, right?
Bath salts.
Wait, is this it? Is this the right one?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, this one. The Oasis Soothing Bath Salt. So what is that made of exactly?
Well, the main ingredient is Dead Sea salt,
okay.
Which is from the Dead Sea.
Okay, so you have to get it, like, from Israel.
It's imported.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's imported. And the scent is similar to the baby oil and the cream.
Okay, so you just dissolve this and
dissolve this in bath water.
Like how much of this would you need?
Maybe a few tablespoons for a small baby bath.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and then parang you just take them banlaw and
soak for a little while.
Yeah.
And if it's really young babies, you don't really have to use soap on them.
Just because their skin is so, not just delicate, but so thin.
Yes,
right? Yeah.
Exactly. And actually, our tap water is very high in chlorine, so that in itself is already drying.
Right, okay. So that's the baby line. Did I miss anything in the baby line? That's 1, 2, 3. There's one more product we're missing.
One more, which is the vocal cream. It's also a cream.
Mm-hmm.
I just took out the ingredients that could be a source of allergy to some people. Like the butter cream has a nut ingredient, which is the shea butter. So I removed that and I came up with something that's more hypoallergenic.
Right, just because something is completely natural doesn't mean that you won't be allergic to it.
Yes,
right?
I have a lot of people who come up to me and say they're allergic to nuts. So this one is totally
nut-free.
Nut-free.
Okay, so for the bigger people, you have your line called Botany Works, and this concentrates a lot on aromatherapy stuff, right? So tell us what you have.
We have among the carrier oils or the base oils, virgin coconut oil and sunflower oil. These are the two of the most popular oils. Very, it's multi-purpose. We have also these are the healing oils, I would call them. Extra virgin olive oil. It's used for any kind of dryness aging skin.
It's not just for your salads or your pasta. Obviously, you can use it on your
Actually,
skin.
What's good for your body is also good for, really good for the skin. We have grapeseed oil, more of an antiseptic oil.
Okay.
And jojoba. The jojoba oil is actually similar to the sebum that our body produces.
Okay.
So it's actually not an oil, but more of a wax substance, and it's very rich and moisturizing. You always find these in, bath products.
So if you have dry skin, that's what you want. It's like you're creating the same kind of oil your body would create anyway.
Exactly. Right. We have also rosehip oil, which is very in demand right now. It's very good for damaged skin and mature aging skin.
Okay.
I get a lot of calls for rosehip.
I was smelling this earlier before we came on, and it looks like
cocoa butter.
It's yellow, right?
Yes.
But it smells like chocolate.
Yeah, that's
right?
Where...
It sounds like you could eat it.
You use that for making a lot of chocolate products, actually. It's cocoa butter, which is very popular for stretch marks,
for the mommies.
Itchiness and dryness.
Right. Okay, now, the thing is, a lot of people use the term organic very loosely here in the Philippines. But when you say organic, it's supposed to mean that the plants and vegetables, that these products were derived from, were grown organically without chemicals and pesticides, right?
That's right.
And these are your products. I mean, we can really call these organic.
Yes, these products are, when I say organic, I always put certified organic, meaning if they want to see any certification, then we can provide that certification that these are really certified organic.
Okay. So what is the price range for something like this? I know a lot of your ingredients are imported. Organic is always more pricey than non-organic. How much would we spend for a few bottles of these, for example?
Well, I try to keep my prices reasonably low so that more people can afford it. So it ranges anywhere from 150 up to, the VCO is only about less than 100 pesos.
Okay, so that's a nice thing about something you can source from the Philippines.
Yes, but even VCO now is going up.
Oh,
the price of VCO is going up.
Malaki yung demand here and abroad, I guess.
Yes, that's true. So from below 100 up to 400 pesos.
Okay, depending on, but that's quite reasonable, I guess. And when you were starting this business again, you said it sort of happened by accident. How much capital did you put out initially?
Initially, for the Oasis, brand, I shelled out just, 5,000 pesos, just to start a little batch.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, it grew. I got my money back in less than 6 months.
Wow, that's great, right? It's not a huge investment, so you don't feel
I did it as money.
Right? Yeah, and you still do it at home, right?
Yeah.
Yeah? So are you the one literally mixing the stuff, putting it in bottles? Is that still you?
Yep. Totally.
Just everything.
Totally. Yeah.
Wow, okay. Talk about a super mom, right?
No, not really. I have some help, but I still, at this stage, I still prefer to be hands-on. I do plan on training some people later on because of the demand.
Right. And this is a business based at home, so how do you balance, you know, Noah, who's now 4 years old, the little one in your tummy, who's coming very soon, and this business? How do you do it?
I don't know. Sometimes I don't know how to do it. But I think it's really trying to set your priorities. Like during the day, during the week even, knowing when you need to prepare or when the orders are going to start coming in. So it's a lot of preparation. But I'm still trying to learn a lot about time management.
Right. And your stuff is available mostly on Multiply, right? How have you been able to get the goods out into the market aside from online?
I have a lot of users who've tried them on their kids, on themselves. And, you know, they're the ones who approach me. They want to become dealers. They want to sell my products to their friends. I have a lot of mothers who have become dealers of Planet Noah and Botany Works.
And they're the ones who go to the bazaars.
Yes, they're the ones who go to the bazaars. They're the ones who market the products out there. And I also have some outlets in the malls.
Oh, okay. All right. But as I said, you know, there's so many people doing this sort of thing, making organic products, personal care products. Do you think there's still room, you know, in the market for more businesses to enter? And for you personally, you know, how do you stay competitive? Because there's so many people doing this now.
Well, I believe there's still a lot of room for organic products, especially the real organic products. I like to mix in organic products with being green, being environment friendly, and that goes with choosing even the right packaging to go with your if the content or if the product is healthy, but you're using a lot of plastic and unnecessary packaging, then that's not really helping the environment.
Right, you might be doing more damage than good for
everybody. So what's good for you should also be good for the environment. So I like to mix those two qualities together, and I think there's still so much room for that, those kinds of products.
Great. Well, we certainly look forward to more things from Oasis and Botany Works. Judy, thank you so much for being on Shop
Talk. Thank you. Yes.
All right. Well, we'll talk about more delicious-looking organic soaps after this break. Stay tuned. Shop Talk will be right back.